Good morning. Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the United States Naval Sea Cadet Corps, Claremont Battalion. I would also like to invite members of our music conservatory to the stage to lead in our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's ranglets, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave of the
Please remain standing for our invocation given by Mr. Troy Urquhart, Dean of the Middle School.
Good morning. Please join me in prayer. Good and loving God, we come to you this morning in gratitude. We're thankful for the successful completion of another academic year and for giving us the opportunity to play a part in the lives of our students, and especially in the lives of these new graduates, the class of 2023. And we're grateful for your guidance and love as we shared in this important work. Please bless and guide our graduates as we mark the end of their time in the upper school and as they begin the next stage of their educational journey. Please help them to use all that they have learned here to make the world a better place, to serve others, to look for ways to help those in need, and to always seek the greater good. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to build our community with these young people during their time here. Although they will depart our campus today, we know that they will always be part of our Montverde family. And we ask that the bonds that have been created here remain strong despite any distance. We ask all of this in your name. Amen. Please be seated.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the graduation ceremonies for the Montverde Academy class of 2023. Woo! They're looking pretty good, aren't they? You guys are looking good. I'd like to welcome and thank our parents, family, and friends, our board of trustees, and of course our faculty and staff for joining us in this celebration. Seniors, today is the culmination of 12 plus educational years in which you have become the person that you are today. This is a time that you can reflect on your personal growth and the friendships you have made over the years. I hope you also take a moment to recognize the army of people, such as your teachers, coaches, mentors, friends, and most importantly, your family, who have sacrificed and dedicated themselves for your benefit. Seniors, sit back, relax, not too relaxed. You still gotta look good. And enjoy today. Today is your day. I would like to invite Mr. David Bernatavitz, Assistant Head of School, Upper School Student Affairs, for the introduction of the 2023 Salutatorian.
The Salutatorian of the Mount Vernon Academy Class of 2023 is Siddhartha Samani. Sid is from Bangalore, India, and has been a student at Mount Vernon Academy since the eighth grade. He has a 4.51 grade point average and has completed 10 advanced placement classes, along with achieving a 4.7 average in all of his AP classes during his tenure at Mount Vernon Academy, and has achieved A's in each of his courses, along with maintaining A's at the University of California, Santa Cruz in summer classes. Additionally, he has been enrolled through coursework at Stanford University, where he earned 100% on his machine learning course. Sid is a published researcher. His article on how our recent advances in society perceived by society was published earlier this year in the North Asian International Research Journal of Science, Engineering, and IT. Sid is a distinguished scholar, a member of the National Honor Society, National Science Honor Society, and served as captain at the International Junior Golf Academy. He serves as a volunteer at First Tee, where he mentors underprivileged children. Sid took both AP Stats and AP Calc this year. I guess he couldn't get enough math to go along with his AP Physics C Mechanics class. His AP Stats teacher, Mr. Samid, says of Sid, he is consistent. His consistent and persistent work ethic throughout was inspiring to see and had a positive impact on all those around him. Sid will be attending Georgia Tech, where he will major in computer science and computer electrical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Siddhartha Samani.
Actually, we're going to put it on the table for you.
All right. Friends, faculty, parents, and fellow graduates, it is my honor to stand before you today as the salutatorian for Montfort Academy's graduating class of 2023. Mom, Dad, glad you can make it. To be honest, I think my dad is a little more nervous about this speech than I am. Looking back to the first day of freshman year, the beginning of this rewarding yet slightly daunting journey, I stand in amazement as to how far we've all come. And I would like to congratulate and thank everyone on this momentous occasion. Teachers, faculty, thank you for being our mentors and the people we look up to when not at home. Mr. Whitfield, you have not only been a mentor to us physics students, but someone who we can confidently rely on for daily sarcasm and traumatizing tests. Parents, thank you for nurturing, providing, and guiding us from day one. Your unwavering support has not gone unnoticed. And seniors, congratulations to you all. We finally get to take on the next chapter in our lives. And by that, I mean we can finally upgrade from SparkNotes to Chegg Premium. In this moment of triumph and celebration, I want to take the time to recall a meaningful memory of mine. As a young boy, I cherished going to the beach on Lama Island when I lived in Hong Kong. I would often find myself entranced by the sound of waves crashing on the nearby rocks, the sight of a flock of birds flying overhead, and the depth to which the view of the ocean extended. As many can attest, high school can at times be an overwhelming and draining experience, whether it be studying the night before an AP exam or cramming 96 chapters of a book in 2 hours because you forgot to read and have an essay due tomorrow. Mrs. Walsworth, I totally did not do this. As a result, the beach on Llama Island became a fond and peaceful memory that I often return to during stressful times in recent years. However, despite the comfort it brought me, I realized that I had not attached much significance to my vivid recollections of it. I recall a specific instance on that beach where time itself seemed to stand still. I was standing on the shoreline as my feet sunk in the damp sand. I glanced to my left and gazed upon a group of maroon rock ledges as an array of waves crashed upon them. Entranced by their seamless elegance, I plodded towards the ledges, and as I drew closer, I noticed that the sides facing the water had been polished clean. As I matured, I started to understand the profoundness of that memory on that beach and its symbolism of life in its entirety. I realized that the rocky ledges represented us as individuals, with each of their crevices embodying our unique attributes and traits, and that the waves crashing upon them symbolized the challenges that we face in life, whether it be physical, emotional, or mental obstacles. Like the waves, the challenges we encounter can at times crash into us with great force, leaving us feeling just like the maroon ledges, bruised and battered. However, being thrashed by the vehement waves, the ledges still appeared to be smooth and polished. I realized that just like how the repetitive crashing of waves eventually smoothened the surface of the ledges, the multitude of challenges or waves that we experience within our life also serve to polish us. The constant pressure and friction that the rocks experience from the waves serve to smoothen and refine their surface, revealing beautiful textures and patterns hidden beneath. Similarly, the challenges we face in life can shape and mold us, helping us to grow and develop into better versions of ourselves. As I look back on this memory now, I've come to further appreciate not only the tranquility that the beach on Llama Island has brought me, but the deeper understanding of myself that it has instilled within me. The waves that crash down upon the ledges serve as a reminder that life beyond high school will not always be smooth sailing, but the challenges that we face can help us become stronger, more resilient, and ultimately more polished versions of ourselves. My message to all of you today is this: embrace the challenges that life throws at you. Find it within yourself to endure the struggles of the present moment and trust that over time they will serve to transform you into a better person. Just like the rocks that are polished by the relentless pounding of waves, we too can emerge from our challenges as stronger and wiser individuals. So let us go forth from this day, ready to face the challenges that lie ahead, with the confidence and resilience that comes from knowing that we are capable of withstanding waves of any size. Just like the maroon ledges, I urge you all to find it within yourself to endure the trials and tribulations, the waves that life throws at you, and remain fixed in place, unwavering, undoubting, unrelenting. And thus, I leave you with this. Look well into yourself. There's a source of strength which will always spring up if you would simply take the time to look. Thank you.
I have the pleasure of introducing our guest performer, Miss Callie Day. Callie has graced us with her vocal talents in several previous events. She is a highly educated, multi-talented, and a gifted woman of faith. In addition to being a classically trained opera singer who sings other genres, she is also an educator, artist, and voice instructor. Her vocal rendition of Moses Hogan's "Hear My Prayer" has made Callie an internet phenomenon. Please join me in welcoming Miss Callie Day.
mercy, mercy.
The valedictorian for the class of 2023 is Trevor Scott Turnquist. Trevor is from Clearmont, Florida, and started at Mount Verde Academy in kindergarten. Trevor has a 4.51 GPA and has completed 13 advanced placement courses. Trevor has taken 31 courses throughout his tenure in the upper school and has earned an A in each of these courses, scored a 1550 on his SAT. All the while being a member of the lacrosse team the past 2 years. Trevor is a distinguished scholar, a member of the National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, Science Honor Society, a commended National Merit Scholar, and an AP Scholar with Distinction. Mr. Stoma states, the valedictorian is a culmination of more than just the highest academic excellence over the course of his high school career. The individual who achieved this honor for the graduating class of 2023 has consistently displayed his talent, intelligence, maturity, and grit. I persistently pursued Trevor during his junior year to take AP language and composition during his senior year. Rarely do teachers campaign to get a student into their class, but his current teachers repeatedly extolled his reputation as a brilliant and diligent student, the type of student I feel fortunate to have the opportunity to teach. Our valedictorian is a young man whose legacy at Mount Verde Academy was firmly established prior to his rigorous senior year slate of 5 advanced placement courses. Trevor Turnquist embodies all of the desirable qualities Mount Verde Academy instills in the future leaders of the world. Trevor is the president of the MVA Honor Council and the head of school advisory council. He serves as a youth ambassador for the Tourette's Association of America. Trevor will be matriculating to the University of Florida and will be majoring in computer science and electrical engineering. It is my pleasure to introduce our class of 2023 valedictorian, Trevor Scott Turnquist.
Good morning, faculty, parents, guests, and
and most importantly, the class of 2023. We're here today to celebrate the culmination of years of hard-earned successes, bittersweet memories, and Ms. Moore's Student Center cookies. After today, we'll go our separate ways along the various paths our lives have taken us. I want to begin by thanking my parents for supporting my journey and goals, as well as my sister, who is joining us from Spain through FaceTime. Especially my mom, because this week she's celebrating her birthday, Mother's Day, and as she likes to call it, her retirement. I also want to thank Ms. Shackelford, Mr. Dell, and Mr. B for their leadership and guidance throughout my 13 years at Montverde. And Mr. Whitfield for 3 stressful years of physics. Ms. Cunningham for fostering my passion for technology and computer science. And finally, my friends Colby, Xander, and Shay, who begged for a shout out in my speech. I'm truly honored to be named valedictorian for the class of 2023 and have the chance to speak to all of you today. For many of us, these past 4 years have been a challenging journey through school, sports, a global pandemic, and Florida's many hurricanes. Through these challenges, we have succeeded, creating a strong, tight-knit class of talented students, athletes, and performers. Earning this distinction would not have been possible without a piece of advice I received from my father. Each summer growing up, my family would drive down to the Keys after school let out for a fishing tournament that my dad's company participated in. The night before the tournament begins, a party is held where all the families come together. While the parents celebrated, us kids would wander the resort looking for things to do. This past year, as the night winded down, a wise old man, as my father likes to call himself, sat us teenagers down to share a lesson that he's given for decades. "Have you ever walked past a fruit tree when you're hungry and thought to grab a piece of fruit?" he asked us. "Your first thought might be to reach for the lowest piece, the one that is the easiest to get. However, on closer inspection, you notice the scratches and bruises from humans and animals trying to get it. Then, you look up the tree and notice a fresh, unharmed piece at the top. But it requires a climb to get to. Do you put in the effort to take the risk for the better fruit, or do you go for the one that is easy to get?" Though my dad was referring to dating, I realized that this message could apply to anything. When you set a goal, you don't give up or accept the first result. You work hard until you accomplish that goal. In 5th grade, when I first applied to the Headmaster Leadership Institute, Mr. Dell asked me what my goals were. I told him that I would be my class's valedictorian and that I would get to MIT. Achieving the first goal was difficult, especially with my Tourette's and severe senioritis. But I took my dad's words to heart, knowing that it was something I truly wanted to accomplish. As for the second goal, there's always grad school. Our commencement speaker today, Hans Hanley, is a testament to the fruit tree story. In his career, he's repeatedly gone for the highest fruit, from being the valedictorian of his class to attending Princeton and working for his PhD at Stanford. The fruit tree does not only apply to school, however. The concept of success is relative. Each one of us has a different set of goals in our lives. Some are shooting for an MBA, and some are shooting for the NBA. Some want to explore the world, while others just want to live a life of comfort. No matter how ambitious your goals may be, you should never settle for less. I'm excited to see where our class will be in 10, 20, even 50 years from now, and I wish you all the best of luck in climbing your tree. In the words of Steve Jobs, the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. As we move on to the next stage of our lives, remember to always aim for the highest fruit. Thank you.
Good job, Trevor. Throughout my years in education, I've had the privilege of knowing and working with a great number of students. In every graduating class, there are those who set themselves apart and are awe-inspiring. Some are amazingly talented in their sport, others in the arts. Some excel in academics and challenge their classmates and teachers to think beyond the norm. Others are genuine, caring, philanthropic people, motivated by simply helping and serving others. All of these students start somewhere and progressively begin to set themselves apart from their peers. As educators, we notice these special students and celebrate that we can be a part of their journey. Mr. Hans Heinle is one of those students who left his mark at Montverde Academy. To this day, when you mention his name to colleagues who were privileged to know him, they will instantly smile and reminisce about the legacy that Hans left behind. Friends and faculty would characterize Hans as a soft-spoken yet hard-charging, intelligent, motivated, inquisitive, caring, and reliable person. Hans graduated from Montverde Academy in 2014 as the class valedictorian. That's a pretty cool thing, but that wasn't enough. Hans went on to attend Princeton University, graduating summa cum laude with a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. Upon winning the Daniel M. Sachs Scholarship, Hans went abroad, where he earned not one, but two master's degrees with distinction in computer science and statistics from the University of Oxford. This should not surprise you, but he is not done yet. Hans has not finished his pursuit of knowledge. He is currently a computer science PhD candidate at Stanford University. His research focuses on natural language processing, computer security, and the spread of misinformation online. Does that really happen? I'll say it again. Hans' research is focused on stopping the spread of misinformation. Personally, if anyone can do that, I believe it will be Hans. Please welcome Mr. Hans Heinle.
Quite the introduction. Faculty members, graduates, parents, and honored guests. Before I start, I want to say that this speech was not written by ChatGPT. So if I sound robotic at any point during my speech, you could blame it on the fact that I've been studying computer science and statistics for the past 9 years. It is an absolute pleasure to be with you here today on this most special of occasions, the graduation of the Montverde Academy class of 2023. My parents, who are here today, grew up in the outskirts of small towns in the Caribbean, so it is very humbling to be asked to give this speech. Thank you to Mr. Urquhart and Mr. Hopman for the invitation. Congratulations to the valedictorian Trevor, the salutatorian Siddhartha, and everyone else in the class of 2023. I know that you all worked extraordinarily hard. High school for you started with the COVID-19 pandemic, but you each endured, thrived, and made it to the end. Congratulations. Montverde is truly a special place. It is the place where I made some of my greatest friends, where I learned some of the key skills that I still use today, where I learned not what to think, but how to think. Without going to Montverde, I will not be where I am today. My family actually moved from central Orlando to Montverde just so that I could attend. So if you will indulge me, I would just like to say thank you to all the parents, including my own, who sacrificed so much for us to go here. I graduated from Montverde 9 years ago in 2014. While today I am a researcher at Stanford studying the intersection of AI and online news propaganda, In 2014, I was sitting in my chair, just like you, waiting for the commencement speech to be over. While 2014 may seem like a long time ago to you, to many of you, and to me personally, for context, in 2014, when I graduated, Joe Biden was in the White House, Russia had just invaded Ukraine, and Bitcoin had crashed in price. Now, 9 years later, in 2023, Joe Biden is in the White House, Russia has invaded Ukraine, and Bitcoin has crashed in price. This is all to say that while 2014 may seem like a lifetime ago, all things considered, it really has not been that long. Saying that, while I do not have a lifetime of experiences to draw upon, hopefully there is something I can say in the next 15 minutes that will be meaningful to you graduates. I thought a lot about what I could potentially say by asking myself, what would I have wanted to know when I was 18? While I think I would have wanted to know that I should have invested in Tesla, the one thing that I needed to know was, what does it actually mean to find your passion? How do you know when you have found it? Like many of you, I can remember people telling me from an early age that I should find my passion. In all honesty, for the longest time, I didn't know what that meant. It was a fuzzy and somewhat trite idea that people always repeated. Kind of like, everything happens for a reason. Live every day like it's your last. Or the Orlando Magic are going to the playoffs this year. You know, things that people said, but they actually didn't believe. Yet at the same time, on average, each of us will spend approximately 90,000 hours working. That's about 10.3 years, day and night. To put that in perspective, you could watch all 9 seasons of the show Friends 1,114 times in 90,000 hours. Or if you got bored of Friends, you could watch everything on Netflix in its entirety twice and still have 16,000 hours left to go. So that is what I'm going to talk to you today about. What do you actually want to spend 90,000 hours doing? How do you figure out what you are passionate about? Well, there are probably some of you in the audience who are thinking, oh Hans, I already know what I'm going to do with the rest of my life. I have a 10-year plan to become a lawyer, clerk for Supreme Court Justice Alina Kagan or Neil Gorsuch, and then open a small law firm in Texarkana. To you, I would say that is great, more power to you. But I want to say it to you, to those of you who aren't too sure, and even to those of you who are only pretty sure, this is your life. You don't get another one. Each one of you owes it to yourself to find out what you actually want to do and who you actually want to be. Not only that, you owe it to everyone around you to be all that you can be. While it can seem that the world is a zero-sum game, with your success meeting others' failure, that is categorically untrue. If you find your passion, the lives of everyone around you will be better. The world will in fact be worse if you are not at your best. People who are passionate go the extra mile, work the extra hour, and are always striving to make themselves the best that they can be. People who have a passion experience a joy, an excitement, a love in what they do. A world where everyone is passionate about what they do is an exciting, fulfilling, and better world. And who doesn't want to make the world better? So how do you figure out what your passion is? In my life, I have found that the key is to remain open to learning new things, open to potentially failing, and open to help from other people. My entire life was once changed by learning something new. When I was growing up, my parents were obsessed, and yes, you were obsessed, with everyone in my family going into medicine. For reference, my dad is a doctor, his brother is a doctor, his sister is a CEO of a hospital, my older sister is in med school, my younger sister is applying to PA school, and my baby sister, who just started college, is pre-med. And so when I first came to Montford, that is what I thought I wanted to do as well. However, at Montford Academy, specifically Mr. Peretz's class, I learned how to code and program computers. It completely changed my life. I can remember being blown away at just getting my computer to spell out "Hello World" in the terminal. To me, it was beautiful that just by writing some lines of code, I can compute any function, draw any picture, and create any world that I wanted. It was absolutely incredible. I could imagine spending 90,000 hours programming. When I was graduating from high school, like many of you, somewhat unsure about the future, I thought programming, for me at least, was the passion that everyone spoke of. This is not to say that I was particularly good at it at first. In fact, I would go as far to say that I was pretty awful. But I found something that I was interested in, something that captivated me, and eventually I got better. As echoed by Barack Obama, if you're walking down the right path and you're willing to keep walking, eventually you'll make progress. That is my advice. If you don't know what you want to do, try learning something new. If you don't even know where to start, look up TED Talks of people that you find interesting on YouTube. If you normally take engineering classes, take a class in philosophy and learn about Kant. If you are a humanities person, take a class in AI and learn about the mathematics behind ChatGPT. And when things get hard, which they will, but if you are still interested, keep going. Don't be intimidated. No one starts knowing everything. And perhaps most frustrating, there will always be people better than you at the things that you love. That is life. But if you're willing to keep trying and keep learning, you will eventually succeed. And while I would love to say that after I learned about programming, that I had found my passion, that my path was set, and that I persevered until today, that is untrue. That brings me to my second point. You have to be open to potentially failing and changing direction. Even though I enjoyed programming, and while it is still an enormous part of what I do day to day, coding ended up not being exactly what I do now. I eventually ended up changing my mind. This all came to a head when I finally interned at a small indie tech startup that some of you may have heard of, Google. While there, probably one of the worst things happened. I found coding to be monotonous. What was supposed to be a dream job, I found to be tedious. I fell out of love with programming almost as instantly as I had fallen in love with it. I could no longer imagine spending 90,000 hours programming. I could hardly even imagine doing it for more than that summer. And even when I went back to school, my passion had seemingly evaporated. I asked myself, what had I even been doing for the past few years? Something had snapped, and I couldn't even remember why I liked computers in the first place. But if I wasn't going to be a programmer, what was I going to do with my life? Everyone, my parents, my classmates, my teachers, expected me to continue down the path I was on. Their expectations, which had once inspired me, now felt like a burden. Every time that people asked me about my future or said that they were excited about one of my coding projects, I could feel that burden multiply. Eventually, it felt like I was going to be crushed. The weight seemed unbearable. Even worse, after coding for so long, I began to have a growing fear that perhaps that was all I was good at. I had won a fellowship to continue studying computer science and was about to graduate with a degree in electrical engineering. If I switched fields, I would be giving all that up. And what if I switched fields and I failed? I felt that my parents and my own disappointment would be too much. I could vividly imagine my father in my head berating me about how I should have went into medicine. So I began to lie to myself and say that everything would be fine. But without the passion that had once fueled me, I became apathetic. I was no longer willing to put in the extra hours. I began to see people that were actually passionate about their work surpass me and move forward, but I was stuck. By being too scared to take a risk and fail, I had begun to fail anyway. After nearly a year of this, I knew something had to change. I was unsatisfied and somewhat miserable. I honestly did not know what direction I should head in. But to my astonishment, as I tried to figure things out, I didn't end up disappointing everyone. The burden that I had pictured in my head was imaginary. And while not the case for everyone, my parents and everyone around me just wanted me to succeed, regardless of what I did for work. So I ended up trying a bunch of different things. I learned Mandarin Chinese, I started doing research on drug design, I even started doing stand-up comedy twice a week in a pub in the middle of England. Throughout that same period, I became hyper-focused on the news. As weird as it is, when I was growing up, my father would always spend Sunday afternoons with me and my siblings watching foreign affairs shows. And now, feeling a bit lost, each day I returned to that habit, but only more so. I would read and reread the news and opinion sections of the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal, from top to bottom. I would get obsessed with the word choice of Bret Stephens in his columns on Israel. I would spend hours upon hours looking up the history of China in order to understand their current events. I would compulsively check 538 and Real Clear Politics to see polling updates on random races in the Midwest. Now, I didn't think that this obsession was ever going to get me a job, that I was going to research the news one day. But I kept up with the news, not because I had to, or because it was a good thing to do, but because I was interested in it, and it reminded me of home. My interest in the news seemed very far off from my degree in computer science and electrical engineering. However, after spending so much time reading the news, I eventually asked myself a very obvious question. Is there a way I could do this for a living? I wasn't going to become a journalist, but was there a way I could take my degree in computer science and apply it to understanding the news? When I started, I really didn't know what I was doing. The progress was slow, and the failures I experienced felt all the more horrible because I actually wanted to succeed. It was important to me. After many no's and rejections, I even questioned whether it was worth it. Though it took time, though, and through painful struggle, I eventually was able to meld my interests in computer science and the news. And now I'm on my way to spending 90,000 hours doing it. Midway through my PhD, my obsession with the news is integral to what I do. That is my advice to you. Even when you think you have found your passion, keep learning. Keep pursuing your other interests, and if you find something else, or if your passion fades, be open to changing your mind. Don't get stuck being afraid to fail. If you don't take actual satisfaction in what you want to do and what you do, you probably need to take a risk. You can only get so far by being apathetic or dispassionate. While today it can almost be seen as a bad thing to change your mind or to change directions, as we take in new information, as we grow, and as we learn new things, we should change our minds, we should adjust, and we should make different decisions. That is something I have found in my life. Even when you think you have found your passion, you could end up only being partially correct or even flat out wrong. Discovering what you want to do does not come in one moment, but is often a longer process. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, you have to be open to relying on other people. Although as I've given my speech today, I focused on what I struggled with when I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do, and while at the end of the day, only you can decide, I was not alone in that process, and neither are you. You have your family, friends, and mentors who are all rooting for you to succeed. These are the people who know you the best, and these are the people who can help guide you. In my own life, it was my dad who first got me interested in the news, and it was my mom to whom I could always confide. No one succeeds on their own. And when you are struggling, these are the people that you should turn to. If you don't know what you should do next or what you should try, ask people that you trust. And when you get to the next stage of your life, and as you attend college and end up in large seminar classes, I urge you not to let that stop you from finding people and mentors that you can rely on. Look up the directory of professors and teachers while you are there, and if there is someone that catches your eye, send them an email. And while this may seem a tad cliche, part of the reason why I ended up at Oxford for 2 years was simply because I sent a couple of emails to a couple of professors. And now that you are about to graduate from Montverde, you are part of an amazing network of people. Both the alumni and the faculty have got your back. If you find yourself stuck, email a Montverde alumnus who does something that you may be interested in. Have a conversation about what they do. Even if it only ends in a conversation, or if they don't respond at all, I can guarantee you that at some point you will make a meaningful connection, and you'll be that much closer to discovering your passion. And also, as a small pro tip, create a LinkedIn. Like, actually, you'll be surprised at the number of interesting projects that people are working on and some of the offers that may come your way. But the key, as I have said, is that you have to be open to relying on other people, especially people older than you. Here at Montverde, I had some of the best mentors and teachers that I could ever ask for, who I could rely upon. Some of these mentors you students have had as well, so you already know how amazing that they are. While I could list them all, I will focus on one in particular, Mr. Ross. Mr. Ross was a faculty advisor for the academic or trivia team while I was here at Montverde. He always pushed me to be better, to study more, and to try to get to higher heights, and to try to know more random facts about French art. And while he passed away my senior year, he left an indelible mark on my life, and is part of the reason that I stand here before you all today. Each of you owes it to yourself to discover your passion in life. But to do that, you need to be open to learning new things, open to taking risks and failing, and open to relying on other people. If you're going to spend 90,000 hours doing something, even if it ends up not being exactly the right thing, make sure it is at least your choice to do it. And even if you disregard what I've said in the past 15 minutes, and even if you do end up being a lawyer in Texarkana after clerking for Justice Kagan, I can assure you, you still owe it to yourself to know that that was what you wanted to do. You need to find something that you want to spend 90,000 hours doing. It won't always be easy. In fact, if you find your passion, your failures will be all the more devastating. Emotionally, failing at something you don't care about is painless. To fail at something that you love hurts. But I can guarantee you that your success will be all the more satisfying. It may take longer than you are initially comfortable with, but the world needs you to be passionate about what you do for the world to be better. And frankly, no matter what anyone else says, each of you deserves to be fulfilled. Since we are here at Montverde, I will mention a quote that I love by John Wooden, a basketball coach. Success is the peace of mind, which is a direct result of self-satisfaction and knowing you made the effort to become the best of which you are capable. I urge you all, don't get discouraged, don't settle, and don't stop striving for better. Keep learning. That is how you will figure out what you are capable of. And since you are graduating from Montverde, I know you all are capable of great things. Thank you. And once again, congratulations to the class of 2023.
I would like to call upon Ms. Shackelford, Dean of the Lower School, Mr. Urquhart, Dean of the Middle School, Mr. Bernatavitz, Assistant Head of School, Upper School Student Affairs, for our next presentation. A long-held tradition at Montverde Academy is recognizing those students who have been with the Academy for a number of years. These students are part of the old, vintage, and ancient guard. As Mr. Dean Bell reads your name, please join us on stage.
So we begin with the old guard, those who have been with us for 4 years. Bennett Thomas Barnes. William Parks Brown. Quan Ching Osman Chan. Lang Yu Jeremy Chen. Jackson James Redvers Cook. Sean Daniel Crosley. Oscar Andres Hernandez Gonzalez. Matthew Raymond Hale. Mia Lynn Hornberger. Seth Gordon Eisenhower. Bohan Liu. Mariella London Malabad. Augustine Ozurum Okpe. Mika Elizabeth Palmer, Annabelle Pisecki, Ryan Aubrey Peterson, Amaral Pierre Jerome, Manuel Ratana Diaz, Elliot Howard Rose, Gabriel Saavedra, Sei Sato Uhara, Mason James Shale, Shangshang Noah Sun, Dylan Hurley Trunow, Victoria Vivaldi, Cody Casper Werner, and Cohen Alexander Woodland. Continuing with our old guard, those who have been with us for 5 years, Tommy Truong Nguyen, Kyle Thomas Johnson, Guy Hudson Coles, Chia Ying Jasmine Lai, Maxime Carl Leroy, Chi Yu Aaron Lin, Sophia Marangoni, Siddhartha Somani, Jack William Turner, Tianyu William Wang, and Jack Christopher Willis. We move now to our vintage guard, beginning with those who have been with us for 6 years. Jeannie Trey Leon Gant III. James Charles Goodis. Scarlett Ella Gunasekara. Felita Goulart Marangon. Shivani Bridges Patel. And James Jin Wang. Continuing with the vintage guard, those who have been with us for 7 years, Roman Luke Aquilino, Quentin Gray Barnhill, Caitlin Irene Bennett, Colton Bailey Cardwell, Esteban Carrillo, Alexa Aurelia Kazanov, Maddox David Colby, Connor Otto Robert Isley, Isabel Grace France, Nicholas Andres Galvis, Leah Marie Girard, Veronica Campbell Newsom, Rafael Angel Ortiz Tenon, Nicholas Peter, Ian William Plank, Alexis Jordan Sells, Connor Sebastian Tafur, and Kendall Lane Walsworth. And we have one member of the Vintage Guard who has been with us for 8 years, Isabella Hannah Zabar. So we move forward to the Ancient Guard, those who have been with us 9 years or more, beginning with those who have been here 9 years. Fabian Ayala Narvaez. Eliana Yariset Negron Lindor. Sienna Celeste Pompeo. Mazen Ahmed Sadek. And Srishti Tandon. Those students being with us for 10 years, Natalie Christine Babinski, Katie Diane Bills McCoy, and Andreas de Fabrique Santour. We have one student who has been with us 11 years, Shailen Ramlal. We have two students who have been with us for 12 years, Lincoln Alexander Baptiste and Anastasia Hope Kreider. We have four students who have been with us for 13 years. Sydney Ann Barker. Gabriella Veronica Palanti. Zachary Brian Spangler. And Trevor Scott Turnquist. And one student who has been with us for 14 years, Isabella Maria Paez. The last special group to be recognized is the Ancient Guard who have been here from pre-K 3 to 12th grade. 15 years at Montverde Academy. For this special group of students, I invite not only them, but their parents to join us on stage. Beginning with Xander Bradley Cunningham with his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Scott and Jennifer Cunningham. Colby Chandler Helms with his parents, Dr. Charles Helms and Dr. Christine Tran. Adam Foster Karen with his parents, Dr. Andrew Karen and Mrs. Victoria Gilgard Karen. Kennedy Grace Fisher Neidig with her parents, Mr. Russell Neidig and Mrs. Jody Fisher Esquire. Natalie Ann Naismith, with parents Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Mandy Naismith. Abigail Nora Ryan, with her parents Mr. and Mrs. Paul and Karen Ryan. And finally, Isabella Grace Salvatore with her parents, Ms. Kate Salvatore, Mr. Randy Lambert, and Mr. Mark Salvatore. And we're going to ask everybody to hold for one moment while Mrs. Braden gets a wider shot. But while she's doing that, please join me in congratulating this very special part of our Montverde Academy family.
Back in 2008, a group of parents trusted that Montverde Academy was the right place to educate their child all the way from preschool to 12th grade. On that memorable day, they held hands and walked their young 3-year-old children into the school for the first time and sent them to class with their first teacher. Moms and dads were invited to stay and share a story to help ease the separation. Together, they all read The Kissing Hand by Audrey Penn and created a kissing hand to have at school for those times when they might feel scared or lonely. The story tells of having to do things you don't want to do, making friends, reading books, and exploring new things. These moms and dads have faithfully supported their child, encouraged them to explore the world unafraid and with confidence. These parents have trusted that each and every teacher at Montverde Academy would help guide and shape their student into the young adult here today, each of them ready for the next step beyond graduation. It has been a long road from that first preschool classroom, though it feels like just yesterday. Today, this Ancient Guard student, as we have called them, is giving their parents a gift of the Kissing Hand book. Inside, you will find a special message from your child letting you know how prepared they are to go on and leave MBA, and that they love you for choosing to send them to school at Montverde Academy. Thank you for your dedication to us and for sharing your children with us. We will forever be grateful.
The H.P. Carpenter Award is named in honor of Mr. H.P. Carpenter, who, along with his wife, founded Montverde Academy in 1912. A pillar in the community, Mr. Carpenter's drive to provide the best educational opportunities in Lake County resulted in the founding of Montverde Industrial School, again in 1912. Providing a strong foundation, Mr. Carpenter's leadership proved to set the tone for 111 years of successful education. This award is given to that senior who, by their performance, has had a significant positive impact on the life of the school. This year's recipient is Alfred Baffi. The Dalton P. Monroe Award is given in honor of Dalton Monroe, who served as house parent and mentor to many students during his tenure at Montverde Academy. Mr. Monroe and Champ, his beloved Boston Terrier, resided in Carpenter Hall, also lovingly referred to as The Rock. He has made a difference in the lives of many young people. Despite his battle with cancer, Mr. Monroe proved to his students by example that his adversity would not conquer his spirit and his wonderful sense of humor. This award is given to that senior who is always able to see the positive side and keep their sense of humor despite significant adversity in their life, and has managed to conquer that adversity and attain success at Montvert Academy. The Dalton P. Monroe Scholarship provides $1,000 academic scholarship to the college of the recipient's choice. Today, I'm proud to recognize Trevor Turnquist as this year's recipient. The Roger R. Ross Head of School Award is named in honor of the 9 headmasters who have served Montvert Academy since its founding in 1912. This award is given to that student who, in all their academic and extracurricular endeavors, has achieved a level of excellence that exceeds all others while maintaining the highest standards of character. Please congratulate Kendall Walsworth as this year's recipient. The Trustees Leadership Award goes to a student who has been at Montvert Academy for at least 2 or more years, and during that time has exhibited the qualities of a leader and has served the school community with distinction in one or more leadership positions. Furthermore, this award acknowledges the student who, during their course of leadership, has performed with a degree of integrity, exhibiting a loyalty to their position and to the school community. This person has also served the Academy faithfully in fulfilling their duties and responsibilities while practicing the highest standards of character. This year's recipient is Osman Chan. I would like to invite Ms. Callie Day back to our stage.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk a stormy sea. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
What next? I can't quite remember what happens next. What? I can't hear you. Oh, my fault. I do believe it is that time we've been waiting for. I'd like to invite Mrs. Renee Lundy, chairwoman of our Board of Trustees, our division heads, for the presentation of diplomas. I'd also like to recognize Mr. Dean Bell, Director of Arts, for announcing each of our graduates. Seniors, you ready? All right, let's do it.
Trevor Scott Turnquist, Claremont, Florida, United States. Siddhartha Somani, Bangalore, India. Natalie Christine Babinski, Scranton, Pennsylvania, United States. Lincoln Alexander Baptiste, Gotha, Florida, United States. Quinton Gray Barnhill, Montford, Florida, United States. Caitlin Irene Bennett, Apopka, Florida, United States. Katie Diane Bills McCoy, Claremont, Florida, United States. Alexa Oralee Kazanov, Guatemala City, Guatemala. Anastasia Hope Kreider, Celebration, Florida, United States. Vernal Edwin Drayton Jr., Hempstead, New York, United States. Nicholas Andres Galvis, Gilroy, California, United States. Sierra Giovanna Grimes, Port Orange, Florida, United States. Leah Marie Girard, Montford, Florida, United States. Scarlett Ella Gunasekera, Claremont, Florida, United States. Colby Chandler Helms, Claremont, Florida, United States. Mia Lynn Hornberger, Turner, Maine, United States. Hannah Elizabeth Huff, Leesburg, Florida, United States. Eugene Byungmo Kang, Seoul, South Korea. Adam Foster Karen, Claremont, Florida, United States. Guy Hudson Coles, Alumet Island, Quebec, Canada. Nicholas Christopher Caracas, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Jia Ying Jasmine Lai, Wishu, Guangdong, China. Thalita Goulart Marangon, Ribeirão Preto, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Olivia Jade McLean, Claremont, Florida, United States. Carly Jean McNatt, Satellite Beach, Florida, United States. Ethan Nemchek, Cleveland, Ohio, United States. Natalie Ann Naismith, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Riley James Novak, Tavares, Florida, United States. Isabella Maria Paez, Claremont, Florida, United States. Shivani Bridges Patel, Claremont, Florida, United States. Sienna Celeste Pompeo, Montford, Florida, United States. Shaylin Ramlal, Queens, New York, United States. Elliot Howard Rose, Apopka, Florida, United States. Troy Edward Scott, Windermere, Florida, United States. Alexis Jordan Sells, Holbrook, New York, United States. Mason James Shale, Sanford, Florida, United States. Zachary Brian Spangler, Orlando, Florida, United States. Srishti Tandon, Easton, Pennsylvania, United States. Victoria Vivaldi, Orlando, Florida, United States. Kendall Lane Walsworth, Claremont, Florida, United States. Cohen Alexander Woodland, Celebration, Florida, United States. Yintong Xu, Songsheng, Shanghai, China. Hibiki Adachi, Oita, Japan. Omar Adekola Adegbola, Houston, Texas, United States. Roman Luke Aquilino, Las Vegas, Nevada, United States. Oluwaseun Victor Akinyi, Lagos, Nigeria. Corey Yvonne Allen, Nashville, Tennessee, United States. Marvell Leon Allen, Wellington, Florida, United States. Antonio Alvarez Pena, Cordoba, Veracruz, Mexico. Stephen Anner Gayamfi, Accra, Ghana. Brady Jake Appel, Orlando, Florida, United States. Berke Arslan, Istanbul, Turkey. Isamata Joseph Asinga, Lusaka, Zambia. Rushni Augustineta, Šiaulė, Lithuania. Fabian Ayala Narvaez, Carolina, Puerto Rico. Alfred Baffi, Tenoso, Ghana. Ayomidi Oluwanifemi Bamisil, Omuo Ekiti, Nigeria. Sydney Ann Barker, Montford, Florida, United States. Bennett Thomas Barnes, Celebration, Florida, United States. Logan Scott Beavis, Longwood, Florida, United States. Justine Ellen Blake, Ketchikan, Alaska, United States. Isadora Costa Reis de Barros Borba, Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, Brazil. Tomas Lima Bosch, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Marco Vincenzo Bulos Giannate, Cuiaba, Mato Grosso, Brazil. Pape Mar Boye, Dakar, Senegal. Dylan Patrick Breen, Waterford, Ireland. William Parks Brown, Claremont, Florida, United States. Hugo Antonio Calaman, Teixeira de Freitas, Bahia, Brazil. Daniel Martin Cante, Gatineau, Quebec, Canada. Colton Bailey Cardwell, Claremont, Florida, United States. Esteban Carrillo, Claremont, Florida, United States. Quan Ching Osman Chan, Hong Kong. Charles Logan Chapman, Apopka, Florida, United States. Liang Yu Jeremy Chen, Taipei City, Taiwan. Yishu Chen, Shenyang, China. Mohamed Lahabi Sisa, Montreal, Quebec, Canada. David Wesley Clement Jr., Rancho Cucamonga, California, United States. Maddox David Colby, Athens, New York, United States. Anthony J. Cole, Claremont, Florida, United States. Jonathan Coleman, Augusttown, Kingston, Jamaica. Jackson James Redvers Cook, Oxford, United Kingdom. Eric Gabriel Correa Rosado, Carolina, Puerto Rico. Constantino Francisco Constantini, Curitiba, Paraná, Brazil. Logan Augustus Cozier, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Sean Daniel Crosley, Orlando, Florida, United States. Xander Bradley Cunningham, Claremont, Florida, United States. Andreas de Fabrique Santour, Guadalupe, France. Tenia de Lima Nunez, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Naomi Viola Drayton, Hempstead, New York, United States. Braden Brent Duval, Englewood, Colorado, United States. Connor Otto Robert Isley, Claremont, Florida, United States. Maria Clara Antonio Oliveira El Cui, Sao Jose de Campos, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Lawrence Elting Jr., Poughkeepsie, New York, United States. Rafael Estrada Zavala, Lajomuco de Zuni, Jalisco, Mexico. Kwame Jamal Gumo Evans Jr., Baltimore, Maryland, United States. Noah Fan, Katsushika-ku, Tokyo, Japan. Isabel Grace, France, Mount Dora, Florida, United States. Arthur Baggio Galvao, Santana de Paranaiba, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Sebastian Gamboa Gonzalez, Merida, Yucatan, Mexico. Jeannie Trey Leon Gant III, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Yilu Lui Gao, Shenyang, Liaoning, China. Jack Garvey, Fort Myers, Florida, United States. Flora Bliss Ganens, Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Batuhan Goktas, Antalya, Muratpasa, Turkey. James Charles Goodis, Winter Park, Florida, United States. Alexis Joel Goitia Torres, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Adam Christian Greg Velazquez, Tampico, Tamaulipas, Mexico. Jordy Ashley Griggs, Moreno Valley, California, United States. Rafael Gubesi, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Kira Rain Haas, Sandy Lake, Pennsylvania, United States. Erica Kana Hagi, Yokohama, Kanagawa, Japan. Hannah Marie Aber, Orlando, Florida, United States. Felix Gabriel Hermida de Moya, Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic. Oscar Andres Hernandez Gonzalez, Kissimmee, Florida, United States. Matthew Raymond Hale, Claremont, Florida, United States. Micaiah Marie Jeanette Holland, Portsmouth, Virginia, United States. Martin Hurtado San Martin, Santiago, Chile. Tommy Truong Huyen, Claremont, Florida, United States. Sebastian Ibanez Perusquia, San Miguel de Allen, Guanajuato, Mexico. Matthew Stephen Ilharegui, Brentwood, New York, United States. Michael Iniesta Exeberia, Getxo, Vizcaya, Spain. Seth Gordon Eisenhower, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Sanaya Marie Ja, Alexandria, Virginia, United States. Kyung Kyung Elena Jung, Seoul, South Korea. Luz Maria Jimenez, Queens, New York, United States. Christopher Ray Johnson, Missouri City, Texas, United States. Kyle Thomas Johnson, Montford, Florida, United States. Isabella Nicole Jones, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Alihan Kunaipia, Almaty, Kazakhstan. One Kadawaki Kashima, Tochigi, Japan. Yamato Kimura, Kuwanashi Mi, Japan. Kishana Taylor King, Chicago, Illinois, United States. Micah Jaden Larry, Harvest, Alabama, United States. Maxime Carl Leroy, Claremont, Florida, United States. Ryan Richard Philip LeBru, Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. Emmanuel Souza Chavez Taniguchi Leite, Campo Grande, Mato Grosso do Sul, Brazil. Ayana Carvalho Alves Leslie, Birdsboro, Pennsylvania, United States. Siyi Lee, Singapore. Chi Yu Aaron Lin, New Taipei City, Taiwan. Alec Michael Lipscomb, Windermere, Florida, United States. Bohan Liu, Shaanxi, Xi'an, China. Mariella London Malabad, Windermere, Florida, United States. Luisa Cancaro Caramati Manata, Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, Brazil. Malang Zakaria Mandang, Dakar, Senegal. Vanessa Manoil, Brossard, Quebec, Canada. Sofia Marangoni, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Melissa Martinelli Marini, Palmas, Paranha, Brazil. John Michael Martinez, Orlando, Florida, United States. Victor Jose Martinez, Orlando, Florida, United States. Ricardo Alejandro Mendez Sanchez, Morelia, Michoacan, Mexico. Julio Jesus Monroy Herrera, Cuxquilican, Edo de Mexico, Mexico. Cade Don Umpia Bosenzo, Amsterdam, North Holland, Netherlands. Iman Victoria Nasser, Damascus, Syria. Eliana Sheraset Negron Lindor, Caguas, Puerto Rico. Kennedy Grace Fisher Neidig, Leesburg, Florida, United States. Lucas Baylor Nevis, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Veronica Campbell Newsom, Apopka, Florida, United States. Zachary Matthew Nolan Murphy, Carrick-on-Suey, Tipperary, Ireland. Zaire Quidar Norden, Newark, Delaware, United States. Babashola Aladapo Zhengbid, Lagos, Nigeria. Augustine Ozurum Okpe, Lagos, Nigeria. Jaime Alberto Olivier Garcia, Torreon, Coahuila, Mexico. Justin Lyndon Orridge, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Rafael Anchol Ortiz Tanyan, Bayamon, Puerto Rico. Sebastian Ortiz Naranjo, Carolina, Puerto Rico. Gabriela Veronica Palanti, Claremont, Florida, United States. Mika Elizabeth Palmer, Montford, Florida, United States. Matthew David Pardick II, Charleston, South Carolina, United States. Annabelle Pasecki, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Nishal C. Patel, Claremont, Florida, United States. Genesis Gianna Perez Watson, San Jose, Costa Rica. Eduard Perez Sala Val, Barcelona, Spain. Nicholas Peter Castro, Salzburg, Austria. Ryan Aubrey Peterson, Eustis, Florida, United States. Amaral Pierre Jerome, Claremont, Florida, United States. Ian William Plank, Ocoee, Florida, United States. Madison Grace Poston, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Muhammad Pouye, Dakar, Senegal. Alvaro Requena Gallo, Madrid, Spain. Manuel Retania Diaz, Orlando, Florida, United States. Luisa Ayub Caldera Rios, Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, Brazil. Alvaro Emiliano Rocha Rocha, Arandas, Jalisco, Mexico. Luis Anthony Rodriguez, Bronx, New York, United States. Abigail Nora Ryan, Claremont, Florida, United States. Gabrielle Saavedra, Pine Hills, Florida, United States. Mazem Ahmed Sadiq, Windermere, Florida, United States. Isabella Grace Salvatore, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. Say Sato Uhara, Mexico City, Mexico. Miracle Lynn Shepherd, Kent, Washington, United States. Maria Eduarda Silva Mendez, Cuiaba, Mato Grosso, Brazil. Diego Sousa Salazar, Alvarado, Veracruz, Mexico. Ella Rose Stedman, Wanakee, Wisconsin, United States. Nathaniel Edward Stewart, Chesapeake City, Maryland, United States. Sean Michael Stewart, Windermere, Florida, United States. Shang Chang Noah Sun, Benxi Liaoning, China. Connor Sebastian Tafur, Leesburg, Florida, United States. Kaylin Lucas Alexander Teodorescu, Hudson, Quebec, Canada. Mia Marie Jordan Thomas, West Caldwell, New Jersey, United States. Josue Daniel Torres Chuck, Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. Ella Louise Tribble, Tappahannock, Virginia, United States. Dylan Hurley Trunau, Tavares, Florida, United States. Jack William Turner, Orlando, Florida, United States. Leticia Miranda Vasconcelos, Capinas, Sao Paulo, Brazil. Mercy Billen Veran, Orlando, Florida, United States. Antonio Vignoli Casey, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Gustavo Coutinho Vieira, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Nitis Vitadanant, Bangkok, Thailand. James Jin Wang, Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. Tianyu William Wang, Qingdao, Shandong, China. Lee Ann Kaylin Waters, Claremont, Florida, United States. Cody Casper Werner, Riverview, Florida, United States. Jack Christopher Willis, Claremont, Florida, United States. Jacob Jonathan Willis, Pensacola Beach, Florida, United States. Yaozhong Uen, Jining, Shandong, China. Isabella Hannah Zabar, Winter Garden, Florida, United States. George Lucas Salitas, Jurmala, Riga, Latvia.
Give them some love, parents. I'd like to invite our senior class president, Veronica Campbell Newsom, to the stage for the turning of the tassels. Another tradition that we have here at Montfort Academy is to invite our alumni to join with the class of 2023 in the singing of our alma mater. If you would like to join, we invite you to the front here, right by the stage. Do we have any graduates in the audience that would like to join us? Besides our most recent that are automatically in on this one. All right, here we go. Led by Montfort Academy Music Conservatory, our alma mater. Sing it loud. Oh, we got some alum coming. Come on. Tyler, break out the chords. Up. All right, everyone. Loud and proud.
This is my Montfort, my home away from home, where friends are friends forever, despite how far we roam. My heart swells with pride every time I see the purple and the gold, the eagle soaring free. And since 1912, we all believe knowledge and good character, diverse community. And though I'll leave someday, in the world I'll be, my heart will always
Thank you. Seniors may be seated. Or graduates, what am I talking about? Graduates! One of my personal favorite graduation traditions is how we close this service with a benediction from around the world. I would like to invite our graduates who are saying the benediction to stage right now.
Bismillah, el-Rahim, el-Rahim. Salam alaikum. Naiz eta bide bezberdinak hartzea, bedintzapienak guzti hoi.
愿上主的祝福在我们里面后跟随我们
que la sogra ens segueixi un cop els nostres camins es separin.
即使我们将各奔东西愿祝福永伴你我
c'est pour bénédiction continuer tomber sous nous.
Mogen zegen ons volgen als we van elkaar vertrekken.
Que nous sommes bénis alors que nous nous séparons.
Möchte der Segen uns folgen, wenn wir uns voneinander trennen.
Che le benedizioni possano seguirci mentre ci allontaniamo uni dall'altri.
Che as bênçãos nos sigam enquanto seguimos caminhos diferentes.
Fie ca binecuvântările să ne urmeze pe toți ceea ce ne îndepărtăm.
Бір-бірімізден аста бара жатқанда бізге бата берсін.
Уриға сорулы танагал те чукпоги хансан хамке хаторок.
Лайсвет ипсмум сакуа кад ширме свецно уатра.
Нарю падекоту саво артемиесам скаче асу.
Que las bendiciones nos acompañes cuando nos separemos unos de los otros.
Бір-бірімізден айрылыркен шанс бізді такип етсін.
Маи сант ньоп муньу фи нек. Yeah, never mind. From Senegal, you don't know.
May blessings follow us as we depart one from another.
I would like to simply say thank you to everyone for being here in support of our most recent graduates. A big round of applause for all of our parents, family, and friends from our graduates. And one last round of applause for our graduates. As we recess, I ask that our guests remain seated, and I ask that our faculty stand, and our seniors, you may stand. Our graduates, I keep calling you seniors, it's a habit. Graduates.